are five documentarians who are going all across the nation to seek out positive stories, and they're here with us today, Bus 52.
Now, this week they happen to be in Idaho and happen to be in Pocatello. We'd like to welcome Amy, Robert, Amy, Stephen, and Chris. Thank you guys for joining us on the show today. So tell us a little bit about what Bus 52 is all about.
Well, basically, we go around the country in this converted school bus, and we make short documentary pieces about people or organizations who are doing something great for their community, something a bit different.
So kind of inspirational stories, yeah. Right?
How many different states have you been to already?
I think we've been to, almost 30 states now? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so quite the road trip.
So when did you guys originally start?
We started it in January, at the beginning of the year, and we're hopefully going through, if we can get funded, all the way through December, so okay. All of 2012.
So you say you're making inspirational stories. Tell me one of the stories that kind of sticks out in your mind as something that you've covered.
Story that I really liked was the Oregon Public House, and it's a public house brewery, a bar that's actually donating all of its funds to charities. So you can go in, get something to drink, get something to eat, and then all of your money that you paid for the meal goes straight to a charity.
Nice.
I love the idea of getting the positive stories. What made you guys decide to do this?
Well, it was all Robert's idea, but he'd been mulling it over for a while and then just ran with it, and we all thought, well, why not? You know, live on a bus for a year and find amazing people.
It's just so crazy, it might just work. So as you guys are traveling, crossing the country, you're coming to the end, you're spending a year out on the road, and you mentioned funding. What kind of funding do you need for this?
Well, we're a 501c3, so we're a nonprofit. We wanted to set it up that way. Right now we need about $20,000 to finish the trip. We've made it about 7 months so far, and we're fully funded through the end of September, but we'll figure out a way to get there.
Still a few more months in the year. Then let me dance over here. I'm going to dance in front of the camera and come over to this side. And tell us about what some of the challenges in driving a bus cross country back and forth.
Rob is the only one who can handle the combination of our manual transmission and this large 40-foot bus. Usually we're fine. Our only challenge is when we're going uphill. This bus was just not designed for that, and we're lucky if we break 25, but the rest of the time it's usually been okay.
Not good for four-wheeling, huh?
Now, if people want to see this, are these online? Have you been producing them as you go along? So can they see something now? Where do they go?
Yes, everything is on our website, bus52.com. Everything's also on YouTube at Bus52 Videos, and we release them every Tuesday and Thursday as we go.
Okay, fantastic. So you guys have a couple more months to go. You're in the home stretch, I guess you'd call it. We want to wish you guys the best of luck. And like I said, you can go to bus52.com. We'll have a link on our website, too, to their website. And we wish you guys the best of luck. And hey, thanks for stopping by today. We appreciate
it. Thanks so much for having us.
All right, thanks. Hey, listen, when we come back, we're going to do some cooking. We're going to be doing beer can chicken with Alex from Rush's Kitchen Supply. That's coming up next.